we have to be fighting tooth and nail for democracy and for the American people.
Mondaire Jones is expected to join Congress after writing support for Medicare for All, the Green New Deal, and canceling student debt to a primary win in suburban New York City. He's a former staffer in Obama's Justice Department and has helped lead the current push to expand the Supreme Court. Jones was raised in public housing by a single mother whose family fled the Jim Crow South. Now, he's poised to become the first Black, openly gay member of Congress, where he'll be able to advocate for the marginalized alongside a growing coalition of young progressives. If you could give one piece of advice to Joe Biden, what would it be?
Listen to young people. We are getting it right in all of these elections. We're certainly getting it right on the policy. We understand that we've only got a few years left before irreparable harm to the planet because of imminent climate catastrophe. We understand that we need racial justice once and for all in this country. And I'm so proud of the young people for leading these Black Lives Matter demonstrations all across this country. We are at the vanguard of not just the progressive movement in American politics, but the reform agenda, including court reforms that we urgently need to ensure that we have an economy that works for everybody, that we have a livable future, and that everyone, regardless of their skin color or their sexuality or their gender, is treated equally under the law.
Will Democrats have more success pushing for moderate, realistic legislation or going for bigger, progressive ideas?
I remember being part of the Obama administration when we couldn't even get a public option passed. Now, a public option is the preference for most Democrats in Congress, when you look at what the consensus view is. Of course, 118 members have already signed on to Pramila Jayapal's Medicare for All Act. And that's because of people like Pramila Jayapal, Bernie Sanders, and John Conyers pushing for Medicare for All. That has been a paradigm shift. Now, everyone, including Vice President Biden, supports at a minimum a public option. It's because folks were pushing for big ideas.
Is there a particular musical artist who's had an outsized impact on your life?
I'm a big fan of music, especially R&B and rap. Frank Ocean is up there on the list. You know, when Channel Orange was released, I was 25 years old, and I'd come out to a few people by then, family and friends, but not completely, so to speak. And so hearing in real time from him that so many of the songs on Channel Orange were written to another dude was something that was really inspiring for me because representation matters. It would have mattered for me growing up, as I mentioned, and it still matters for other people. And that's why I'm so grateful to be showing the kind of leadership and visibility that I'm showing.
What is your message to Democrats who oppose Supreme Court expansion?
None of the big ticket items that Joe Biden has run on this election cycle are able to withstand judicial scrutiny from that high court, absent court expansion and court reform. What they also fail to understand is that democracy itself is at stake. This is a conservative majority that is hostile to democracy itself, even before Justice Barrett became confirmed. And so we've got to make sure that we act like it, that we work in earnest to expand the court in order to provide the unfettered right to vote, which I believe is a fundamental constitutional right that should not be infringed upon in the way that state legislatures led by Republicans all across this country have been dealing with the Supreme Court as an accomplice.
You used to work for the Department of Justice, vetting judicial nominees that were often blocked by Republicans in the Senate. What did that experience teach you about how to approach politics?
Fresh out of college, I worked in the Office of Legal Policy at the Department of Justice. Part of my portfolio was vetting candidates for federal judgeships. These were well-qualified nominees, according to the ABA, which is a criterion that the Trump administration has completely dispensed with. These were nominees willing to say they supported Brown v. Board of Education in their Senate confirmation hearings, unlike Trump's nominees. That's just something we used to take for granted as this bedrock principle in American law. And what I saw was, regardless, Republican obstruction until we started to change the rules under Majority Leader Harry Reid in the Senate. And I don't regret that. I think we saw that we started to get judges confirmed, whereas prior to that time, they were writing articles about the historic slow pace at which Barack Obama's nominees were getting confirmed to the bench. What that taught me was that we have to be fighting tooth and nail for democracy and for the American people, and not subordinating those interests to a minoritarian form of government.
What did this summer mean for the Black Lives Matter movement, and what's next?
More people than ever before in this country view racism and police brutality as problems in this country. That is an opportunity. It is an opportunity for people like me and for anyone else of good conscience in Congress to undertake the kinds of policing reforms and criminal legal system reforms that we urgently need. But of course, also understanding that systemic racism extends beyond the criminal legal system and interactions with police officers. It's in the way that we choose to fund our public schools in this country, a largely property tax-based system that concentrates tens of billions more dollars in white communities and deprives Black and brown kids of critical educational opportunities. It's the way that we condition the ability to get necessary medical care in this country on how much money you have in your pocket. I'm excited to get to work with respect to that. It is an opportunity unlike any other in modern American history. And we've got to continue to march and rally and protest. And I'm so grateful to young people in particular, all across this country, including white people and people of color, who understand this and who have been leading these demonstrations.